In this tutorial, we will see the last miscellaneous topics of C-Suite. Well, it is possible to import, export all or almost all parts of the program POU, that are the strategy pages. We have done this in the exercise regarding alarms. It is possible to export, import the global and the local variables, the configuration in C-Design, or a specific sub-configuration like the protocols, the photo values, and so on. So almost all can be exported, imported. NFC support, so all models of CPCOMINI and some models of the newer hardware revision of CPCO have a NFC tag. It is 8 kilobyte that basically is a retained memory that can be written written, of course, using a compatible NFC writer like the ones of the most popular smartphone. Very interesting that it is possible to read write it even when the CPCO is not powered on. From the application point of view, you can read write that memory using specific function block, NFC read, NFC write. And it is available a demo application for CPCOMINI and an Android app to test this feature. So with this system, the application saves the configuration and operating parameter in the NFC memory, like the set point, for example. And using the Android app, it is possible to read it, change it in the smartphone, and write back to the NFC. The application running in the controller detects that there is a new value in the NFC tag and will read it and write in the retained memory of the controller. So, in short, the NFC memory can be read-write from the application and read-write from the app in the smartphone. If you are interested in this feature, you can get in touch with your local branch. Standard applications. So there are four standard applications for C-Suite. The first is DC Compressor Chiller, previously called Mini Chiller. This is a software meant for high efficiency chiller. It manages a chiller and heat pump unit for CPCO and CPCOMINI, up to two circuits, up to three on-off compressors. The first compressor can be a BLDC compressor, so it manages also the Karel Power Plus inverter, it manages the electronic expansion valve, it manages also the functions necessary to manage the compressors like the envelope, the oil, manages also the other devices of the unit, like the evaporator pumps, the condensing fan, the condensing pump, and so on. Later in this video, I will open it and will show it. Second is ventilation. It is an application meant to manage unit with active and passive heat recovery and for compact air and unit. Combo driver somehow is a reduced version of the first, but that manages only the compressor part. Manages a BLDC compressor plus two on-off compressor, also the electronic expansion valve driver, the power plus, of course. Also this one manages a chiller and heat pump unit, the envelope, the oil, the source side, but doesn't include the temperature regulation, so it receives the cooling demand from an analog input or from BMS. So this is very interesting to test the high efficiency, the Karel high efficiency system, and somehow also for retrofit. The last is the computer room air conditioning, also called the closed control unit. Very interesting is the duty standby function. Well, if you are interested in this software, you can contact your local branch. The binary files and the user manual of the DC compressor chiller are available also in KSA, in the section for boot and BIOS and standard applications. Now I open the DC compressor chiller standard software so we can see the difference between the real life, that is a real application, and a small application like the exercise of this tutorial. So this is the last version of the exercise. You see only few POU, few strategy pages, quite simple or quite simple. Also here in the masks, only few masks. The device loop is quite empty. Okay, now I open the standard software. So here is, so rather than 6-8 POU, there are maybe 20-30. Let's open a couple. This application is based on the project template. So what we see here in the on-off unit is what we have seen in one of the previous exercises. Also the general management is the one of the project template, I think is as is. Okay, let's open some other POU. This is for the temperature regulation, for the PID, set point. This is a very well documented. I remind you that in KSA there is the user manual of this application. And so if you are interested in this application and to modify this application, I strongly recommend you to study the manual first and then open the source file and try to understand what this done, because if you know how works this application, will be much more easier to understand what this block do. Temperature regulation, free cooling. You can see that basically is what we have done in our exercise. Also here there are variables that can be global like this or also local, connected to blocks, connected to other blocks, with other variables, to other blocks. So this is like very similar to our exercise, but with more blocks, different block, more variables, longer chain of blocks, but it is, you see, it's not so different. Remember that this is a quite big application. It is not a demo, it's a real big application for a real unit. So the oil, rotation of the compressor, VLDC compressors, okay, EVD driver, source devices, okay, I won't open all these variables, all this POU. Well, this is the strategy of a real application. This is the real life, let's say. Quick look to the masks. Also, this is based on the project template. So probably you recognize this part where there is a startup logo, language selection, main mask with a quick menu. This is the menu. On off, set point. Okay, so more masks, but somehow the masks are defined as in the exercise. There are text with this object, there are variable object like this. This uses the raw zoom here is to show some values in 8. There are images. Images, in this case to write in reverse. There are functions defined in the code. There are classes, in this case not just one special class, user class, but a little bit more. but more or less is like the one that we have done in the previous exercises. In C design, there are not two. Remember, we have created two configurations, chiller two compressors and chiller four compressors. Here there are more. One for the CPICO medium that manages two circuits. So, for example, the input and outputs is for all the six compressors of the two circuits, while for the CPICO Mini there are several configurations. For the CPICO Mini normal model, not remember what is the exact name, or the high-end model for the first circuit or for the second circuit, but more or less is what we have done before. So there is an input-output configuration, here is a protocol configuration, default values, here are. So it is what we have done in our exercises, but more, simply bigger, more, but all the concepts are the same. Well, go back here. So these are the standard application. Repeat, if you are interested in these standards, you can get in touch with your local branch. These are some links to documents, these are in Italian, links to some examples and tutorials on the languages used by the system. These are in Italian, but I remind you that the system uses standard languages, so in internet you can find millions of documents, also in English and also in other languages. Next steps. Because there are other 10 minutes of tutorial, then we'll start your real life with the C-Suite. So these steps are my suggestions for your phase-in in the real life. First of all, buy the starter kit. That is the C-Suite license. If you are using a trial version, you know that it lasts 90 days and then you won't be able to modify the application. So you have 90 days to buy and receive the license. And then the simulator box. There are two simulator boxes, one for CPICO and the other for CPICO Mini. Here are the part numbers. The simulator box is a box where inside there is the controller and some electronic components that allows you to simulate the inputs and the outputs. Regarding the inputs, input of any type, that is NTC sensor, 0 to 1 volt sensor, 0 to 10, 420 milliamps, passive, and so on. You are able to simulate also the digital inputs, the digital output through LED, analog output, and so on. There are also the optional cards. In case of CPICO, there are two optional cards, two RS-45 cards, one for the BMS 2 and the other for the, sorry, one for the BMS 1 and for the field bus 1. All connectors are remoted outside, all along the borders of the box. So there are connectors for all the five serial ports, the two USB ports, the Ethernet ports, and I think it's all. After that, a PGD1 terminal. This is not mandatory, it's optional, but an external terminal in your hands is more convenient than the build terminal that is in the side of the simulator box. And then the phone cable to connect the PGD1 to the simulator box, and then the USB to RS-45 converter, that is the one that we used in the exercise of protocols number 18 and 19. The three wires cable to connect the converter to the BMS or field bus port, There is no part number, so you have to make yourself. If you are interested in other cards, for example the long cards or the KNX cards and so on, you can get in touch with your local sales office. Next, study the language reference. I mean the basic function block, the ones in the standard library and the Karel basic lib library, the system variables, CMask statements. Well, study or at least read the title, the short description of this, because if you don't know what are the objects that you can use in a real application, you won't be able to create easily and quickly a real application. So read at least the titles. For example, regarding function block, okay, I told you that there is an online and offline help. Here are offline and online. They are very similar. The difference is that the offline help is updated with the help available when we have created the setup, while the online, of course, it is always updated. So when you press F1, the system opens the online if you are connected to internet, as it opens the offline one. There is a small difference between them, that is, in the offline help, this one, all topics are in the same place, so that is here you find the help of the editors, the standard library, that is here are the functions and the function block. You see that they are divided in categories. There is the name of the block, and the titles. So I strongly recommend you to read at least this, just to know that there are blocks for comparison, there are counters, there are blocks for the average, and so on. So go back. In the offline help, there are help of the editor, standard library, and at the end, all other libraries. The basic, advanced, and devices. While in the online, they are divided. Here you find the help of the editor and, like before, the standard library. Remember, function block. The help of all other libraries are not here, but in another section. So this link point to this section, see library. So here you find the help of the blocks of all other libraries. So third parties, devices, advanced, basic. So read at least the titles. So just to know that there is, for example, a block that counts the working hour. So you don't have to create from scratch a block or a strategy for the hour counters, because it is already available. So read at least this title. Then system variables. The easiest way to find the list of the system variables is rather than open here, is find for system variables. Here is. So these are the system variables, but I remind you that the system information are not returned only through system variables, but also through function block. Here are two function blocks, system read and system write. So some information through system variable, other information through system read, system write. Okay, now I go back here. system read here is. So here are the description of all the system information. So quick read of all these things. And the CMask structured text statements. In this case, the easiest way is rather than open somewhere here. Ah, I'm lucky, just open here. Is. They are a little bit hidden, so another way is search here for a statement that you remember well, like go to mask or go to loop. And here is the list of the statements. So also in this case, read the short description, so you know what you can do when you press a key. Next step, read or study again these slides, this PowerPoint presentation, and also the quick reference that you can find in case. So I remind you that you can find all these documents in the C Suite area, training. Here are the slides and the quick reference. Because the quick reference and the slides together contains, let's say, the 90% of the knowledge that you need to develop an application. So take your time to read and study again. Consider that in these 32 tutorials, I didn't open all the slides and read all the sentences. But all the slides and all the sentences are important, so take your time to read everything again. After that, make practice. So you can start creating a simple project. If you don't have an idea what you can do, an idea is write again the chiller application. Another good idea is to modify a standard project like this, like the mini chiller I mentioned before. After that, well, sooner or later you will need help. So how to get help? Again, there is the user manual that I mentioned before, the online and offline. There are video tutorials, what you are watching right now. I don't know how you get this tutorial, but I remind you that there are two ways. You can download the tutorial from the training area, from here. So you can download and watch offline. The alternative is watch them in streaming in YouTube. So you can copy this link. It is not an hyperlink. So you have to copy and paste. So there is a specific channel containing all the C Suite tutorials. Need help? Again, you can find information in these slides, the quick reference, in the FAQ, here, again, in the C Suite area, FAQ, the frequently asked questions. And as last option, ask for support. The preferred way is email, and in case of a very urgent issue, also the telephone. How to get support? Here is an email address. Actually, this is a generic email address managed by Karel, but in your case, you have to ask help to your local branch because the first level support is provided by the local branch. In case the local branch is not able to sort out your problem or doesn't know the answer to your question, the local branch will get in touch with headquarter. So behind the local branches, there is a current headquarter. A support channel is KSA. Again, where you can find, but at this point you already know, you can find the latest version of the setup, of the operating system, of the libraries, demo tutorials, generic documents regarding these topics, again the training resources, templates, that is the latest version of the project template and of the webkit. and I just mentioned the FAQ. I remind you once again that the user manual of CPICO contains a lot of important and useful information regarding not only the hardware, like this part, or the wiring, like this part, but also the system menu, like here, so description of all the entries of the menu, but also other features like the protection, password protection, and so on. Well, that was the last part of the last tutorial of C-Suite, 32 tutorials, where we have seen, I will say, all the important feature and function regarding the suite. So we started with an overview of the connected platform. We have seen the complete life cycle of a project, that is how to create a new project from scratch, and later with starting from the project template, how to edit it, strategy, user interface, the configurations, how to test it, upload into the controller. We used a couple, two of the four programming languages, FBD and ST. We've seen how to create a simple user interface. We've created, I think, six or seven masks. We have debugged the application in the PC with the debug simulation and also online via USB and also via Ethernet. We have seen how to manage protocols, master and slave. We've seen how to create configurations of input and output, configuration of protocol, of logs, Terra, and so on. And how to manage libraries, how to insert in an application a device library block. And we've seen the operating system services, USB, the protocols, FTP protocols, and also others, what is possible to do with the Ethernet port, and the web support with the web server. Well, this is really all. I hope that you found this tutorial helpful. And now, what can I say? Enjoy developing your application with C-Suite. Thank you for watching.